an 18, 22-year-old kid, when they walk in the room, I want them to say, wow, unbelievable. What is that? What is that? So I'm just like, Bert, we've known each other for a while, and Richard, and they know the kind of training I do, and you know the style that I have. And I basically looked at him, I said, hey, brother, build me something special. Just build me something. You know what we do. Build me something special. I said, put your passion and your love into something, because you're a Gamecock, your dad's a Gamecock, your whole family's been Gamecocks. Let me tell you something, just take a look. That's all you gotta say. Just take a look at it, because it is phenomenal. Phenomenal, and the ability to do just about anything you need to do, that's the key.
I was a senior here 20 years ago, 1999, graduated track team. So to be able to come here and to see what we're able to do for the university, and that they still trust in me and my family to perform for them, much as I did 20 years ago, my dad did 50 years ago. It's a family thing, and it's something that I'm super proud of, because I'm a Gamecock, I bleed Garnet. Like you said, I already knew what you wanted, I already knew what you were doing, so then it was, how do we make the most innovative tools for what you're doing as an innovative coach? So you have things that no one else has, and just by playing with this, your staff is coming up with exercises that haven't been done with those specific tools, because those tools didn't exist. To know that a coach of your level is going to be able to do some amazing things with these tools, I can't wait to see a year down the road and what you guys have come up with.
Thing about this facility, guys don't want to leave. You know, you see them here all the time. You almost have to kick them out to go to class because they want to stay here and train. It's awesome.
I get to help the next Bert Sorin that's coming through the University of South Carolina. You know, I'm playing a very small part, but I get to be a part in someone else's story, and it lives on.